Go have a look.
What do you think?
Oh my God.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I think I need to go back to portrait school.
I think if he was at school, he'd have been put standing in the corner by now.
Okay.
But we give him a big bowl of us and give Daniel a big bowl of us. We have a really strong team.
I'm going to do one more, slightly more serious drawing.
So those of you who like drawing now, you can watch PJ and see how he does it. And ask for charcoal tomorrow.
Yes.
You have a big bag of charcoal?
Big bag of charcoal.
Have you got any nice white clothes?
Okay, well I'm going to do a very quick one now, because I haven't got too much time left. But it's, these are the kind of things that charcoal is really good for. And you can tell me when you start recognizing something coming through.
I know you told me before, PJ, you don't draw on white.
Yeah, I always like to draw on grey. It's sort of saves you a lot of trouble. It'll get you halfway there. And then I use a rubber to draw stuff into.
Look at that, that's really cool. He's using the rubber to do the lines instead of like a pencil.
Okay, this is going to be not as critical. Anyone
and
know
when
what
you
it is
see
yet?
Something, tell us. What is it?
What? A wave. Yeah. Castle. How can you see a castle? You're brilliant. You jump right to it. But look, I'm going to try and make the shape a bit more clear, just using the rubber, you see that? That's what...
So would you advise parents, PJ, who are at home, trying to do a bit of drawing with their kids? Is charcoal a good thing?
Charcoal's a great thing, but the kids will get very messy. Yeah. We look at my hands and I look really messy. But it is, it's great, it's the best fun, and you can get lovely effects.
And I think you said before, when you've finished, don't you have to spray it with something to stop
you
it?
You do, you have to spray it with something called fixative.
Okay. Top tip.
And you get really atmospheric effects using a brush like this. And I thought I would do some... It is a castle, guys. But it's a castle by the sea. There's loads of castles out in this part of Ireland, aren't there? There you are.
And PJ, do you think it's true that some people can't draw?
I think it might be true. I think everybody can improve by just applying themselves to it. But it's a little bit like music. Some people are tone deaf and really can't get the music. But I'd say 90% of people can draw. And
is it about practice?
And I would say 100% of people can have a lot of fun drawing.
And is practice hugely important, like music?
Yeah.
If you want to be good at drawing?
That's the same with almost everything. Writing, music, acting, everything. Okay. So I'm going to try and put the C in here, guys, very quickly. Using my rubber. No, that's
the rubber is such a good trick, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because you can really see the line.
Does it look like the sea yet, or no? It doesn't?
There are a lot of art critics in today.
Well, give me a few minutes and hopefully it'll look like it. You know those pictures in the books that I do? I usually spend 2 weeks on that. And this is more like 15 minutes, so... You don't get the full effect.
And that 2 weeks, are you having a lot of cups of coffee and talking to your friends on your mobile phone?
Might be doing a little bit of that, yeah.
Because look how quickly he can do it when he tries.
I know. I should do more books in charcoal because they're very, very quick.
Yeah. Now Christmas is coming, so you could ask Santa for PJ's books, which are fantastic. The Boy Who Fell Off the Mayflower, or the Once Upon a Place is also a great book. If you don't like big long books, Once Upon a Place is all short stories. And it's got loads of well-known Irish writers in the book. And it's got all these lovely drawings by PJ. Hands up here, who loves drawing?
Everybody, are you all going to try this technique? Yeah, some of you are.
Yeah,
good.
Try this.
Okay, now the fun part, and I'm just going to finish with the fun part, is when I put a few little lights in.
Who lives in that castle, do you think?
A witch.
I think an evil person lives in that castle.
There's a ghost in there. Like, because I can see an eye and a nose and kind of a face.
Really? Wow. Oh, wow.
Who said they thought an evil person lives there? Did you? Yeah. What kind of an evil person?
I think it's like,
maybe a witch. Be a good picture for Halloween, wouldn't it? It's pretty cool.
But you see, you guys are all natural storytellers. If you can come up with ideas like that, just from looking at a picture. Do you all write your own stories? Sometimes? You do?
Yeah, some people, yeah. What kind of stories do you write? I'll come down to you.
I like to write fantasy stories, maybe, but that's
very hard. And would you do any illustrations with them?
Yeah, a lot of the time.
Good boy, well done. Because we're going to need lots more writers and illustrators coming up.
Okay, guys, I'll just put a little figure in here to make it look mysterious. What do I have? Over here? Keller Clown. I don't think so. Somebody with a cloak. A witch. A
now, is that still the charcoal you're using? Just
here. Yeah, this is charcoal, yeah. It doesn't look like what? It is, yeah, it's very black. That's what's good about it.
Yeah.
Look, it's like Gandalf, isn't it? Lord of the Rings.
It is a very good idea. Give us that again.
Somebody's trying to fight the person in the castle.
Yeah, somebody's trying to fight, trying to attack the person in the castle.
Ah. I love it that you guys are coming up with your own ideas, right? And we'll have a little bit of light falling from the castle. And when I sign this, you guys have all got to applaud like crazy, because it's really tough standing up. Now just wait till I applaud it. I wait till I sign it, and then a big round of applause, because it's very embarrassing to stand up and draw. But I have to fix a couple of bits first.
Let him do his kicksings. What he doesn't know is that Galway people have the best bulbas, the best clapping. So when he signs it, we're going to make the biggest noise. And if you're doing this at home, remember, you do need to spray it, because otherwise it'll all disappear. Here we go, he's going to do it. Go!
In record time, right before our very eyes. So thank you very much, PJ and Trish. And just before we finish up, folks, and thank you for being with us, I just want to mention as well that the festival is going to kick off tomorrow. And as any of you who still haven't managed to secure all your tickets to go to our brand new shiny website, which is Bavaro.ie, something that very important people that I didn't thank earlier are the wonderful team at Bavaro. Incredible amount of work goes in all year round to bring this festival together, and we have an amazing team of staff and a huge number of volunteers, and we simply couldn't do it without them. So thank you so much to all of the wonderful team, all of the work that we've made. As I say, the space will be changing all week long. It's fantastic to see kids already making all sorts of wonderful things here. It's lovely to see these boys already on their own voyages of discovery. And thanks again to Orla and Deirdre and to Recreate for all the materials and to the wonderful team here working in this space. After this evening's opening and after we officially declare it open, we'll have some refreshments for you all. Just to let you know that an exhibition as part of the festival is going on, an exhibition installation in the Galway Arts Centre in Dominic Street, and that's kicking off at 5 o'clock this evening. So if you haven't had enough art, please do come and join us at 5 o'clock for that opening. And I'll hand over to PJ again.
Okay guys, thank you very much for that, for being so kind. But some of my drawings are a bit ropey, but some of them. Thank you very much to Aisling and the organisers of Bavaro for inviting me. It's a great privilege to be here today. Also thanks to Nessa, who's my minder, for looking after me, as she always does. My role as Laureate de Nogue involves trying to raise the profile of children's literature. And Bavaro is raising so many different art forms, but including books, writing, and illustration. I think it's wonderful the work that Bavaro has been doing. It's kind of natural that Bavaro has evolved in the sort of creative cradle of Galway. It's one of the most artistic cities in Ireland, I think. And it's no coincidence that Bavaro has developed here and has evolved into one of the most successful arts festivals for children in the whole world. So I'm very proud to associate myself with it. Bavaro inspires and delights children and has been doing it for 20 years. It gives them the chance to enjoy theatre, dance, musical events, poetry and puppetry and parades, all sorts of things like that. And there are art exhibitions, as Aisling was saying. There are a bunch of very good Irish illustrators going to be talking tomorrow. Please don't miss that event. So all kids get to take part in all sorts of creative activity as they're doing today. And I think that's really, really good for them. The Bavaro people believe that the arts enhance our experience of life and expand our worldview, and I totally agree with them. I think that our children, when they're born, are beautiful and they're a lot of hard work, and then they're very cute when they're a few years old. But kids can be, young kids, not talking about the older kids can be very selfish. They're only interested in their own needs. And they can be kind of cruel and vicious, and we have to teach them to be kind and to be caring and to be thoughtful. And I think the first time that they start to understand the world from other people's point of view is when they start understanding stories, when they start reading books or having books read to them, and they start watching movies, and they start seeing plays, and they start getting the stories that are in songs as well. And they start to see things from another person's point of view. And I think that's a really important part of developing as a human being. It's called developing empathy, and it's absolutely essential. And I believe that the arts, personally, I'm into books in particular, are really essential for that process. But if the book is good enough, or if the movie's brilliant enough, you don't notice that you're learning something because you're having so much fun. And that's the ideal way for kids to learn and develop. There's going to be a lot of fun had over the next few days with Barbaro. I've had a look at the program. It's absolutely brilliant. It's very, very exciting. And there are going to be people coming from all over Europe, all over Ireland. Don't forget the illustrators, as I said. And it's going to be a really amazing festival. I'm delighted with my laureate medal on. It's a very great pleasure for me to officially declare Barbaro